Okay, I'm Marcus. I am the best man. Hi. Yeah. And for the sake of time, I'm going to keep this nice and short. So, Joe, you got me on the clock. All right. No, I just wanted to say thanks to everyone for coming to celebrate this special day. It means a lot to Tyler and Kayla, and this is just an awesome wedding, an awesome event. I want to thank the bride's parents and the groom's parents. Thank you for putting this on. You guys did a great job. And most of all, congratulations to you two. I've known Tyler all my life, so it means a lot to him, I can tell. Tyler and I have been friends since about third grade. And the funny thing is, he still looks the same, as you can see on those posters. Yeah. Same beard, same everything, minus the chubbiness. But yeah, ever since third grade up until our senior years of high school, we were probably on the same sports team every single year. So I've gotten to see him grow and change into the man that he's become. And you're my best friend. And we've been through it all together. We've cried together. We've laughed together. We've fought each other. We've been grounded together. We've gone through it all. But I really don't know why Tyler stayed friends with me. Because he'd always come over to my house, and one of two things would happen. My brother Michael, who is like a bully, and people don't know him, but he'd either bully Tyler, or Tyler and I would play some sort of game that I created. I made all the rules, I made all the points, and I'd win like 20-0 every time. But he kept coming over, and I love him for that, so I don't know. But there was one game that he did create. You remember, Tyler used to collect bouncy balls. He had huge ones, small, and bouncy balls are hard now, so if you get hit with them, those things hurt. He had red ones, blue ones, black ones. But the game was called Bouncy Ball War. And what it was, okay, we had about four or five guys, and you turn off all the lights, you get a handful of bouncy balls and hide, and then once you said go, you whip them around the room and chuck them at each other. Yeah, and we never told Tyler this, but we always knew where he was hiding, because he'd be breathing, he'd be like, so we knew exactly where to throw it, but... I'm not sure what I was more scared of, getting hit by a bouncy ball or having Lori find out that we were playing that. Yeah, because I know either of us would not be here right now if she knew we were playing that game. But to get serious, Tyler is one of the hardest working people I know. We all know he's very talented, but what differs Tyler from a lot of people is his skill set, and the difference between talent and skill is talent comes naturally, and talent wanes. But when it comes to skill, that's something you work at and you perfect and you grind and grind and grind and get better. And that's what Tyler does all the time. When we were growing up, it'd always be like, I'd ask him, yeah, Tyler, you want to do this? Tyler, you want to do that? And he'd be like, yeah, no, but I got to get up my shots first. And Lori was in the driveway making him shoot anyways. So, yeah. But he's always been a hard worker, and I just want to thank you for let me be your best man, and you're my best friend. You always will be, and I'm happy for you. No. Kayla, you look beautiful tonight. You look gorgeous. I don't really know you too well, but I have gotten to know you a little bit. And for what I've seen Tyler talk about you and the way he looks at you. I can tell he loves you. He's always been really picky. I know. But I've never seen him so giddy towards anyone in my life. So I'm really happy for you guys, and thanks for inviting me. And that's it. So if everyone wants to raise their glass to Tyler and Kayla.
Lot to follow, Mr. Sherrill's here. So I'm Mandy, one of the two maid of honors. I went to college with Kayla, and she was my first friend at USC, and she took me under her wing, and I will forever be thankful for you. So Kayla has this song. Kayla goes to the bar and sings karaoke to this song once in a while. Kayla marches on stage by herself to this song once in a while. So I've arranged a little ditty here from our friend in the corner.
Thank you.
now. I think you know it, so. You can stand down if I don't have it. There you go. Oh, you do.
Hold on.
I have not met a better man in a long time, so give it up for Tyler Kane. I'm so proud of you guys.
I'm Natasha, or Nat. I'm the other maid of honor. And I'm going to start off by saying I'm really glad it's Tyler standing up here and not Blake Griffin. She's obsessed. Yeah. When thinking about my speech and what to say, I was like, well, maybe I should talk about some embarrassing times that Kayla and I have had together. Like when we got booed off stage trying to sing the song that we all just sang. Or how we used to practice our club charm moves in Kayla's bedroom. Sure, those would be entertaining stories for everyone, but I didn't really think Kayla would appreciate that much. So instead, I decided to talk about Tyler and Kayla through numbers. So just kind of bear with me. Hopefully it'll all make sense in the end. The first number is lucky number 7. This is how long I've known Kayla. We met on the dance team our freshman year at USD and became friends instantly. We have a million great memories, like dancing on the stage at Kodak Theater, or our recent trip to Jamaica, where we rapped Baby Got Back and did not get booed off the stage. We also tried to live together for a year, and we both found out quickly that that did not work out too hot. But we managed to survive, and we've been closer than ever. That's how you know you found a true friend, and Kayla's been that for me. And I'm so honored that you asked me to stand up for you today. The next number is number 30. This is the number Tyler was wearing when Kayla first caught his eye. They met our freshman year. Tyler was leading USD's basketball team in field goal percentage, rebounds, and blocks. And that year, Kayla figured out what that meant. The following year, Tyler must have been trying to show off for that pretty little face cheering on the sidelines because he led the team in field goal percentage, rebounds, steals, and blocks. 14 is the next number. It seemed like every year the basketball team had an away game on Valentine's Day. It never failed. But Tyler always came up with an elaborate plan to make sure that Kayla still felt very special, even though he wasn't there. The first time he asked me to help her, I knew that the beast on the court was developing a soft spot for my best friend. The next number is easy, 6, the date these two made a commitment to each other for the rest of their lives. These two are now one. They say marriage is full of ups and downs, full of ups as well as a few downs. But just remember to stay true to each other, be supportive, communicate, keep an open mind, and always remember your faith. Live as Ephesians chapter 4 says, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit and the bond of your peace. Remember this, and hopefully in 50 years, the final number, we will be celebrating with your children and grandchildren the prosperous life you guys have led. Okay, now here's where the numbers come into play. This morning, when Kayla and I were at Hy-Vee getting coffee for everyone, I bought a Powerball ticket. using these lucky numbers, 7, 30, 14, 6, 1, and 50. I'm not the type of gambling person, ask Safety Kayla over here, but I would bet on these two. I bet on their loyalty, not only to each other, but to their friends and family. I bet on their trust for each other to guide them along their journey. I bet on their love to keep them close, even if they might be countries apart. And finally, I bet on the commitment they made today. I've never met two people who complete each other like these guys. I'm so happy for the both of you. And if you would all raise your glasses, I'm gonna end with a toast that Kayla and I say a lot. So, here's to you, here's to me. Here's to Kayla and Tyler living happily.
I just want to welcome everyone. This is a great pleasure for us, and I hope you guys are all having fun. I don't want to say a lot today, don't want to talk, but I didn't want to get this mic in my face at all, but my daughter is important to me, and that's why I'm doing it. Kayla, we're very proud of you. Couldn't be happier to see you and Tyler together. Your mother and I knew that we had a very special little girl growing up, and I'm trying not to choke up here, because I got a lot of people I work with. Just so you guys know that the sheriff is in the building, so. Okay. But we watched you grow into a special little girl that we watched as a loving, caring, beautiful woman of God. And that's very important to us. Every father hopes that a young man that his daughter meets will be smart, reliable, sensible, and considerate. And I believe Tyler has all these qualities. I've not had the opportunity to spend a lot of time with Tyler, but I do know that my daughter thinks the world of him, and that means, that says everything to me. Sorry. This day came a lot sooner than I thought. Not that I felt that Kayla rushed into this, but it's just that one day you have a little girl, and she grows up, and the next thing you know, she's a young woman starting her own life. Now, that's pretty tough for any of you guys have daughters. I'm sure you know that. Tyler and Kayla, I just want to say that there's much love in this room today. A wedding is not only about the love for each other, but the love that you share with the people in your life, and most importantly, the love that you have for God. You're among friends who wish you all the happiness and love in the world. And I just want to say good luck in your marriage, and may God bless you both. Thank you.
Okay, my dad told me he was not going to make me cry, so he did the exact opposite of that. We just want to thank everyone for being here. We had a lot of people come from so many places, and it means a lot to us that you all came here. We have so much love and support, and we just really appreciate all you guys. And I'm going to give this to Tyler so he can say something.
You know, first of all, I'd like to thank everyone for being here. The parents, thank you guys very much. Everyone who helped Kayla put this wedding on. Believe it or not, I had little to do with this wedding and the planning that went into it. It was more or less just me show up and kind of whatever Kayla did. So, you know, a big thank you to Kayla because she worked really hard on this to make it special for not only us, but everyone that's, you know, here with us tonight. So thank you to you. And you did a very wonderful job with it. I just can't say how great it is to see everyone here tonight. You know, if you don't know, you know, I've had the opportunity to travel the world, and you know, I'm not in the States a lot. So when I am, and I get to see all my friends, family, people from all walks of life, and you know, my new family here tonight, it means the world to me and Kayla. So thank you guys, and I hope everyone enjoys themselves and has a great night tonight.
and the land is dark, and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry. No, I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand by me. And darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me.
If you need a friend.